In 1988, the B-2 officially joined the ranks of the U.S. Air Force's bomber fleet. The world's first stealth bomber, the B-2 was designed to penetrate deep into enemy territory and strike at targets no other aircraft could possibly hope to reach and survive. With 3 decades worth of stealth technology under its belt, America's Northrop Grumman Aerospace and Defense Company is now set to deliver the U.S. Air Force's next stealth bomber, the B-21. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're taking a look at all we know about the ultra-secretive B-21. Secret barely describes the B-21. The U.S. has traditionally been extremely protective of its stealth planes, and with good reason. In 2008, after a year-long operation, Chinese hackers successfully penetrated a few American contractors' secure networks and managed to steal some design secrets of the F-35. Years later, those exact same design features showed up in China's attempt at a fifth-generation fighter, the J-31. Yet while there's serious and multiple reasons to doubt China could manage to build a fleet of J-31s that could be on par with American-made F-35s, China's pilfering of F-35 secrets is not something the U.S. is willing to repeat. Thus, the B-21 long-range bomber program has been wrapped in so much secrecy that even American congressmen have expressed serious frustration with the program. In 2017, the late U.S. Senator John McCain rallied against the Department of Defense in a hearing after even the Armed Services Oversight Committee was denied information on additional spending for the B-21 program. As one analyst jokingly put it, well, we know it can fly, and fly it can, really, really high. In 2016, Northrop Grumman released a single promotional image of the B-21 Raider, revealing a flying wing design much like the B-2 stealth bomber. But unlike the B-2, the B-21 does not have the kite-like body of the B-2. From this single design feature, we can ascertain that the B-21 is meant to fly much higher than the B-2, at minimum, in excess of 60,000 feet. That's because the B-2 was originally designed to fly at this height and had a body designed without the kite shape it has now, and closer to the B-21 Raider. But late into the development program, a nervous U.S. Air Force grew fearful of stealth technology. Not knowing how effective the technology would be in the long run, or how fast rivals could develop technology to detect a stealth bomber, the U.S. Air Force grew cold feet at the thought of investing hundreds of billions of dollars into a next-generation bomber, whose only defensive measure was stealth. Thus, they forced Northrop Grumman to redesign the plane so that it could fly low to the ground if need be, in order to avoid radar the way non-stealth planes do, flying low and fast. This design change necessitated an expansion of the aircraft's fuselage to accommodate more fuel required for low-altitude flight and help generate lift, giving us the B-2's distinctive kite shape. But as history has shown us, the U.S. Air Force should have had more faith in their plane. While peer competitors such as Russia and China have developed more advanced radar and remote sensing technology, the likelihood of not just tracking but getting a weapons-quality lock on an American B-2 is extremely low. The best method of tracking and engaging a stealth plane is to use an infrared targeting sensor, but these require very close proximity to the target aircraft and give an operator a field of view similar to trying to scan the entire sky while looking through a straw. Confident in new developments in radar-absorbent materials and other classified stealth breakthroughs, the U.S. Air Force has this time given the go-ahead for the B-21 Raider to remain an extremely high-altitude aircraft, apparent in the plane's design and reduced fuel load, as it takes less fuel to fly at higher altitudes. While its maximum ceiling is still classified, it's a safe guess that the B-21 will fly at minimum the 60,000 feet the B-2 was always meant to reach, but never did. The B-21 Raider, however, will be much more than just a bomber. Although it will be nuclear capable, as current B-2s are, the Raider is also designed to be an airborne communications node, loitering deep in denied airspace and relaying data from its own powerful sensors to other aircraft or even satellites. It will also be able to network between various American military assets, sharing data between squadrons of planes and giving every U.S. plane in the air a complete picture of the battlescape. This means that a B-21 will be able to loiter over hostile airspace and detect enemy aircraft or ground installations. Then, thanks to advancements in U.S. battlespace networking, it will even be able to direct long-range missiles fired by other American aircraft safely outside of harm's way to their targets. While the F-35 has similar capabilities, it cannot fly as high as the B-21 will, and with its very high perch, a Raider will be able to see far more than an F-35. Another thing we can confirm about the B-21 Raider, thanks to a Freedom of Information Act request, is that each aircraft will be able to be operated manned or remotely, something no other aircraft in the world can do. Within 2 years of reaching initial operational capability, each B-21 in the U.S. fleet will have the ability to be remotely piloted or even have it fly nearly completely autonomously, bringing a human into the loop to make final targeting decisions. This will allow the Raider to fly into the most hostile and denied airspaces in the world without risking American lives, threatening targets that current peer competitors might have assumed for a long time to be unassailable due to the risk involved. The U.S. Air Force has plans to purchase 100 B-21s, and fully confident in its stealthy features, it has shown no signs of getting cold feet at the last minute. This will be critical to achieving the Air Force's goal of acquiring 100 of these super advanced aircraft, as the B-2 is notoriously expensive, running up to $1.5 billion apiece. This staggering cost is why the American B-2 fleet has always remained so small, at just 20 today. Yet the B-21 Raider is not expected to reach these astronomical costs, given that the reason the B-2 became so expensive is because it never reached economy of scale. The U.S. government simply did not purchase enough that Northrop Grumman could mass-produce them cheaply. And with 100 B-21s on order, each individual aircraft will become cheaper to buy as more are built and manufacturing techniques are perfected. Yet the total price tag for the B-21, or what each initial plane may end up costing, are kept tightly under wraps, with the Department of Defense denying even the American Congress any insight into total costs, citing national security reasons. America's B-2 stealth bomber is projected to remain in service for another 2 decades to come. Yet with Edwards Air Force Base officially becoming a test site for the B-21 just this year, it's likely that within the next few years the B-2 will be sharing the skies with the world with its next of kin, the B-21 Raider long-range bomber. While its full potential will remain a secret, much like the B-2, it's clear that the B-21 is set to become a revolutionary aircraft the likes of which the world has never seen. What do you think the B-21 may be capable of? Does the public deserve more details about something their tax dollars are paying for? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to watch our other video called "Why Does the B-2 Stealth Bomber Cost $2 Billion?" Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as ever, see you next time.